Hi viewers, welcome to VS Channel. In this video, I am going to explain the analog to digital conversion process using successive approximation method. So first we can see what is ADC, and then we can see the operation of successive approximation ADC conversion. ADC is an electronic device that converts analog input voltage into digital representation. The output of ADC is an integer that is proportional to the magnitude of analog signal. The purpose of ADC, that is the need of ADC, is the MSV430 can access analog information and digital information. But all the microcontrollers and microprocessors are digital devices, that means which can process only digital information, which understands only digital information, that means a binary information. The analog information is does not understand by the microprocessors or microcontrollers. For that, we need to convert the analog information to digital information based on that digital information which can process the information. So here the microcontrollers can access so many sensors. The sensors can sense the environment changes and provide the electrical signal, that is analog signal. That particular analog signal does not understand by these microprocessors and microcontrollers. So that these devices should have the ADC. That particular ADC can convert analog information into digital information. But in MSC430, we have ADC circuit inbuilt of MSC430 microcontrollers. Now we are going to see the conversion process of analog information to digital information using successive approximation method. The successive approximation converters have been the general purpose of ADC for many years. The resolution is typically 10 bits to 12 bits. The speed can reach mega samples per seconds. For some reasons, the name is expanded into successive approximation register, so far which is called as SAR. Now we can see the process. Here we are going to consider an example to explain the process that converts analog information to digital information. So here I was taking the input voltage as 0.4 volts, 0.4, that means 40% of input signal, right? So here 0.4 VFS means in full scale we are going to consider 40% of signal as an input that we are going to convert into 4 bit of ADC. So here this particular graph we can show that how we are going to convert. First we are going to take the full scale range, that is from 0 to 8, and that particular is divided into two equal parts, and then we are going to compare this input voltage comes into the first half or second half. That process I can explain step by step immediately. So first here the input voltage is compared with a midpoint of 1/2 of the VSS of the full range. That means we are dividing the full scale range of input voltage, that is voltage, into 2, that is 1/2 of VSS. And here we have two ranges from 0 to half of the VCC to 1. So now we can check the input voltage that we are considered, that is 0.4 VFS, is present in first half or second half. For that, here we can take the condition. The condition is V in is less than half of the VFS, otherwise V in is greater than or equal to half of the VSS. So here we are considered 0.4, that means definitely the 0.4 VFS is present less than half of the VFS. That means the condition, that is the first condition, is becomes true. If this condition is true, then the output becomes 0. So that we can get MSB bit as 0, right? And then we are going to take, now the full scale we are going to consider like 0 volts to 1 by 2 VFS. That particular range we are going to consider as a full range now. Now that is divided into two equal parts. That means the midpoint, that is 1 by 4th of VFS, we are going to take as a midpoint. Now we are going to compare the input voltage is less than this 1 by 4 VFS or otherwise greater than or equal to 1 by 4 VFS. Now this we can check. The input voltage is 0.4 VFS, that is not less than of 1 by 4th of VFS, that is greater than the 1 by 4th of VSS. That means now the second condition is satisfied. So that means V out is becomes 1. Now that particular V out we are going to consider as a next bit in the digital output. And now we are going to take the full range, that between 1 by 4th of VFS to half of the VFS. That range we are going to take now. In that range we are going to select the midpoint. The midpoint is 3 by 8th of VFS. Now we can compare the input voltage is less than 3 by 8th of VFS or greater than 3 by 8th of VFS. So 0.4 VFS is greater than 3 by 8th of VFS. So that again we can have a choice to satisfy the second condition, that is Vin is greater than or equivalent to 3 by 8th of VFS. Then that becomes 1. Now the output is becomes 1. And then we can take the selected area, that is 3 by 8th of VFS to 1 by 2 of VFS is the full range. And now we can take the midpoint of this, like this midpoint is becomes 7 by 6th of VFS is the midpoint. Now we can take conditions like Vin is less than this midpoint, that is 7 by 6th of VFS, or greater than 7 by 6th of VFS. And here that is the two conditions. Here also this satisfies the second condition. 0.4 VFS is less than 7 by 6th of VFS. That means the output is becomes 0. The output is becomes 0. That means here this is becomes 0. That means the output is 0, 1, 1, 0. So that is this particular digital output. So this is the process of converting analog information to digital information. So this is successive approximation. First we are going to take the input voltage, and we are cutting the full range into two equal range. Midpoint we are taking, with the midpoint we are compared. After completing of that, again we are taking the another range as a full range. We are taking two equal points, again we are comparing with the midpoint. So like this we have a chance to convert any bit of resolution of digital signal, that is analog voltage to digital voltage, digital signal, based on this successive approximation. I think this video is provided required information about the conversion process of analog information to digital information using successive approximation. Please like this video and share this video to your friends. If you are not subscribed VS channel up to now, please subscribe my channel, that is VS channel, and thank you for watching this.